Time now for baseball from the great state of Texas and Globe Life Field. Here it's the little guys on the big stage between the Columbus Clippers and the Durham Bulls. It's baseball, it's the show, and it comes your way next. Ready now is Gabriel Arias. He'll get us started in this one under the lights. Now a swing and a miss, and he's behind one and two. And not a bad night for baseball, an even 70 degrees here at game time. Oh, and a good curveball gets him swinging for the first out of the evening. Stepping up is Tyler Krieger.
Tyler Krieger.
The 1-1. Taken on the outside corner for strike two. Neither guy willing to give in, and the at bat will continue. Looking for back to back K's to start the game.
I got to count 2 and 2.
Breaking ball misses the corner, 2 balls and 2 strikes. Ball 3 and 2 now.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
Fouled off. And he lays off here, ball 4, and he'll become the game's first base runner here with one away. Now at the plate, Nolan Jones. First shot for him here with a runner at first now and one away. The 1-1 is swung on and missed for strike number 2. Krieger, a runner at first with one gone in the inning. Well below the knees, laid off on the changeup there. So a full count now.
We could see the runner in motion here on a 3-2 count with one out. There's a pretty good chance he's going to get a pitch to swing at, and if not, it's ball 4 anyways.
A payoff pitch one more time. Left side.
Batting fourth, the first baseman, number 22, Josh Naylor.
So now to the plate, Josh Naylor, fouled away. And he fouls this one off. Now another 1-2. And a fastball blew it right by him, and there are two down. So now here is Daniel Johnson looking to put them ahead early with this at bat. Ready with the 1-1. Almost caught looking to end the inning, but it's called ball 2-2.
Now 2-2. This is the pitch where you want to attack the zone. If you go 3-2,
we'll leave it right there as he strikes out, and that ends the inning. Now into the box, Vidal Brujan. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. The 1-1 home.
That's ball 2. You got 2 balls, 1 strike. That's ball 3.
Jordan Luplo waits on deck. The 3-1. Hit hard down the line. But a foul ball, and it's full now at 3-2. And a half swing that time, but it's a full swing in the eyes of the umpire, and that'll be the first out of the inning.
Batting second.
Now to the plate, Jordan Luplo.
Luplo.
in for strike two.
Put that in the memory bank. First time he breaks out a curveball right there, and it's a pretty good one.
Oh, and he can't catch up to the fastball as he swings and misses for the second out. And now here is Josh Lowe. He'll attempt to put the ball in play for a change here with the first two guys going down on strikes to start the inning. And a good job there to lay off. It's ball four as he becomes their first base runner of the ball game now with two away.
First baseman.
Full count here. Here comes the pitch. Hard hit ball to second. He's got it. And as it turns out, the two-out walk doesn't come around to haunt him as that ends the inning. At the plate now is George Valera. He'll get us started in the top of the second. The 2-1 is laid off up for ball number three. And it's fouled away. The next 3-2. And that misses for ball four. So it's a leadoff walk here to start the second. Next up, Ernie Clement. First chance for him here with a man on following the leadoff walk. The 1-2 is taken for ball two.
He went with the off-speed there once he got him to 0-2, but now that they both missed, I think we'll see more of a challenge pitch here. You don't have to get in, but you can't be too cute either.
And he wasn't going to hit that one with an or the strikeout, and there's one gone. Up high, 2-1 now.
Count is 2-1.
Now a throw over to first. Three and one.
That's a great call right there. Fastball away with a guy who's got some jets on first base. Almost like a hybrid pitch out. Great for a catcher if that guy's running. Easy transfer throw to second base.
And that misses ball four. So it's first and second now with only one away. Now at the plate is Aaron Bracho. And this one's low here, so the count swells to 3-1.
3-1 here, you have to make a good pitch on the mound. Grooving one here rarely works in your favor unless the hitter tries to do too much with it.
The 3-2 pitch. Early swing there as he pulls it foul to the right side. The next 3-2. Pulled high in the air out to right field. Luplo is there. Two down. So the batting order turns over now and set to go Gabriel Arias. Two's all over the place. Two on, two out, and of course, here in inning number two. And there's ball three on a breaking ball that misses away.
Boy, his pitch count has really spiked here in this inning. He's up to over 50 already.
And he comes back with a fastball. Strike three called, and the inning is over. Last half of the second set to go, and that'll give way to the third baseman, Grant Kay. The 1-1 home. And he can't get out of the way there. So the leadoff man will be aboard to open up the inning. Next, it'll be Nick Schnell. And he fires a fastball now for a called strike two.
A good fastball above the belt is normally a pitch that batters love to take a rip at, but that one froze it.
Still even at 2-2. Foul ball. 2-2. Is swung on and missed, strike three. To the plate now is the designated hitter, Michael Brasso.
The designated hitter, Michael Brasso.
The 1-1. Runner goes for second. Fouled off. The 1-2 is looked at for ball number two. Bottom of the second here with no score. Outside and a full count, 3-2. Taylor Walls is on deck. Timing just a tick off there as this one's fouled off to the right. The next 3-2. And he misses here for ball four. Already two walks surrendered in his first couple of innings of work. So now into the box is Taylor Walls as he'll dig into the left-handed batter's box. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
Great chance right here as a hitter to be really aggressive. With two guys already on, pretty good shot. He's going to get a challenge pitch right here.
Lifted the other way down the left field line. But this is just going to wind up being a foul ball. And he holds off on the breaking ball, so the count runs full.
I don't think he can afford another base runner here, so whatever pitch he feels best about, whichever one he feels most comfortable with, that's the one I expect him to turn to.
And look out. That's in very tight, and it's ball four.
The catcher.
And now, Joseph Odom. And a golden opportunity here to give his guys the lead with three men aboard. And there's ball two now.
One thing's clear. He's not afraid to pitch inside, right? One pitch ducks him away, then he comes right back with another one. So clearly this pitcher, he's not afraid to work that inner half of the plate.
3-1 to him now. Hitters count all the way. Here it comes. And it's up to a 3-2 full count now. And this is swung on and missed. Oh, a huge punch out there as the bases remain loaded with two away now. Kane at third, Brasso on second, Walls on at first with two down. 1-2 now as that one's fouled off.
Lucky he got a piece right there. He was definitely late on that pitch after seeing a previous off-speed pitch.
A swing and a miss as he chased with two strikes, and that will retire the side. Top of the third set to get underway, and set to go is the switch hitting outfielder, Tyler Krieger. He's ready. Now the payoff pitch. Changeup, called strike three as he rolls his eyes at the call, one away. Next, it'll be Nolan Jones, a base hit in his first trip.
Yeah, guys, still the only hit in this game so far. They've been pretty well shut down. Guys on the mound have really much controlled the whole outcome up until this point.
I love everything this pitcher's got working right now. He's got presence. He's got great body language on the mound. He's got fastball command and a nice early feel for his off-speed stuff.
In complete control now. Seven strikeouts as this is swung on and missed for the second out. Next will be the cleanup hitter, Josh Naylor. Two outs already on the K this inning, so he'll be looking to do better.
Nope, that's the ball.
And they'll go off speed here as this pitch misses. It's 2-1. Here's a big swing and a miss on the fastball. 2-2.
He is in complete command out on the mound today. He's got all four corners locked in, and now he's raising eye levels to boot.
He stays alive, still 2-2. And now a pitch on the way.
That was kind of a gift to the hitter. He's up there probably thinking of protecting on 2-2, but when you launch a ball that high out of the strike zone.
Looking at a fastball to end the inning. third now, and next it'll be the outfielder, Jordan Luplo. Driven nicely into the gap. He takes the turn and heads for second. And he is into second base with a leadoff double. In now, Josh Lowe. High in the air out to center field. Valera is right there, one down. Into the box, Jim Haley grounded out in his last at bat. Now a flare out toward right center. Bracho is calling for it. He's got it, and there are two down now. Up next, Grant Kaye. Maybe a little extra motivation for him here after being hit by a pitch in his first at bat. 3-1, here it is. Bottom of inning number three, nothing our score. And that misses, ball four, so it's first and second now with two out.
Now batter.
Next here is Nick Schnell, 0-1 for him here in this one. And a check swing here as he couldn't help himself, and it's ruled strike two.
Yeah, Matty, you see the same pitch three times in a row and you find yourself down 1-2 in the count. Your head starts.
Threw it right past him. A swing and a miss at the gas, and that ends the inning. So stepping in is Daniel Johnson as we begin the top of the fourth.
I know we're not seeing a lot of offense in this one, but there's still some game left. I'm looking to see these guys, both offenses, make some notable adjustments at the dish and try and scratch a few runs across.
Wow, that's four straight K's. He's knocking them down. He's looking for number five right here. You can tell this guy on the mound, he is pitching with a whole lot of confidence in this one.
He throws him on the fastball there. Daniel Johnson becomes the first out of the inning. Lifted into center field. He'll take this in without much trouble, and two are gone here to start the fourth. Striding forward now is the DH. Bernie Clement struck out in his first at bat.
Sometimes you just got to tip your cap to the guy on the mound. He's getting paid to try and get you out as well. Anytime it gets up there north of 7-8 pitch ABs, sometimes it just comes down to pure execution. Let's see if he makes the adjustment right here.
Here now the 2-2.
Three balls, two strikes.
Still hanging with him. Another good swing to keep it going. Another full count pitch home.
Nope, that's down.
And this is taken low for ball four, and they'll have themselves a two-out base runner here after all.
Now batting.
So next to hit is Ryan LaVarnway. He drew a base on balls his first time up. And he comes back with a fastball. 1-2 now. Fastball well outside. Hoping to send him packing. Pitch on its way. Too high. Ball three. Hard hit ball to second. Fielded cleanly. They'll whip this one to first in time, and that ends the inning. Ready to go for the last half of the inning, and that'll bring up Mike Brasso. Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. And this is swung on and missed, and this fourth inning will start the same way he ended the third with a strikeout. There's one away. Pitching has the upper hand early as we're scoreless in inning number four. And he struck him out, and that's eight strikeouts thus far.
Now batting.
Next to hit, Joseph Odom trying to avoid becoming the third strikeout victim of the inning here. Down the left field line and deep. And that will end up a foul ball. The 1-2. Just one hit apiece for both of these clubs. Went to the slider to try and get him to chase, but it's full now, 3-2.
Well, he really needs to make this guy swing the bat right here. He's not the type of hitter you want to dance around with.
Oh, and he lets him off the hook there, as this isn't even close for ball four. Lifted the other way to left center. And no trouble for him as he makes the catch to end the inning. Digging in, the switch hitter, Aaron Braccio. A matchup with Tyler Glasnow to lead off the inning. 1-1. Swing and a shot toward right center. Luplo moves to his right and puts this one away in the alley for out number one. Now back to the top of the lineup. Stepping in, Gabriel Arias. 0-for-2 on his line thus far. The 1-1 home.
Obviously, he's not fatigued whatsoever. Still in the mid to high 90s with his fastball. These guys got to stay on the attack if they're going to have a chance.
2-2 the count. Got him. And he goes down on strikes for the third time. So next to bat will be Tyler Krieger. He went down looking in his last trip to the plate.
Yeah, Maddie, and hopefully he got it out of his system, especially now he's got a bear down. He gets the two strikes in this spot, has to put the ball in play.
And here in just the fifth inning, this will be pitch number 100 here.
Boy, pitch count up near 100 right now, D-Row. And this is when you try to get to a good starting pitcher. Right now, looks like he's running on fumes.
Yeah, the manager's got to get a couple people up in the bullpen right now. One ball hits the gap. They get runners in scoring position. This game could be out of commission.
Good battle here. This will be the seventh pitch coming up. And yet another strikeout here. His 11th of the ball game, and this one ends the inning. Daniel Espino gets the call from the bullpen to pitch in relief.
Number 34.
So now to the plate, Jordan Luplo. He doubled his last time up.
Well, he got a good pitch to hit last time up. Looked for it up in the zone and didn't miss it. Those are the pitches you only get maybe once an AB, maybe once a game, maybe once a week. So he certainly capitalized on it last time.
The bouncer to the left side. And that's out number one. So the next to bat will be Josh Lowe. He's 0-for-1 thus far. Now the 1-1 pitch. Hit on the ground is short. Oh, look at the sliding stop. What a play. Stepping in once again is Jim Haley. 0-for-2 for him to this point. Now the 1-1 pitch. Misses, ball two.
2-1.
Two out, nobody on. And strike three called as he says, you got to be kidding me, with the side retired. Number 75 is ready, and he'll take the ball from the manager.
Number 75.
Striding in is Nolan Jones. He's 1-for-2 in the ball game. Swing and a miss. 2-2 now.
Two strikes.
that's taken high for a ball. It's full now, 3-2.
Well, that sets up a big pitch right here, Matt, because you don't want to lose the leadoff guy in a scoreless game. It's tough to work around the leadoff walk.
But this is right at him in right field as he hardly has to move to take it in for the first out. And stepping in, Josh Naylor. He was punched out looking at strike three last time through.
Yeah, Matty, and he was locked up by a good fastball for strike three last time. I'm interested to see if they attack him the same way. Come at him with hard velo late or snap something off in the dirt to see if it'll fish.
Ran it in on him as this is bounced toward short. Scooped up, and that's the second out. Next to hit is Daniel Johnson, who struck out in his last trip to the plate. Bases are empty here with two men out. There's a fastball well off the plate for a ball.
Two balls, one strike, the count.
Fouled away. Another try at 2-2. In tight. Look out. That one sends him to the deck. It's ball three. Swinging a ball hit on the ground. Hit hard on the ground to the right. And that is through into right field for a single. Throw over to the bag.
And
he'll get dirty, but he's back in safely. Stepping in now, George Valera. A swing and a miss there, 2-2.
When a pitcher puts you in the proverbial rocking chair like he's doing right now, you have to take a deep breath. You can't start trying to guess along with him. Trust your fundamentals and stay on that fastball.
He's set, and the payoff pitch. He got him. Lively fastball that time, and it puts an end to the inning. Now at the plate, here is Grant Kay. It was a walk in his last trip. Swinging a ball hit on the ground, but a foul ball, 1-2 now. Into the windup and the pitch. And he'll lay off the curveball that's in the dirt that time, and it's back to even now at 2-2. Hit in the air out to center field. Valera has to roam straight back, but he has it for the first out. So here is Nick Schnell. He struck out swinging in his last trip to the plate. Bases are empty, one man out. To two balls and two strikes now. Full count now, 3-2. Now the payoff pitch home. Is a called strike three on the corner. Mike Brusso digging in at the plate. Comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ball game. Here's a looping fly ball out to right. In there, the base hit.
The batter number 6. Shortstop.
Into the box now, Taylor Walls. Grounded to the right. It's flagged down deep in the hole. Throw to first with time to spare, and the side is retired. Seventh inning ready to roll, and stepping in will be the very fleet-footed Ernie Clement. And not a real good cut at that slider, and he's behind 1-2.
Hey, that was a nasty pitch right there. Ton of rotation on that ball.
A swing and a drive sent out toward the gap. And there's your go-ahead base runner right away as this is down for extra bases. And your go-ahead run is in at second base here with a leadoff double.
Now
standing in now, Ryan LaVarnway. Lifted in the air out towards left center. Schnell, a range to his left as he tracks this one down in left center for the first down. And he is in there at third as the possible go-ahead score. Next to dig in, Aaron Braccio. He's 0 for 2 in the ballgame so far. Here now the 2-2.
Well, this is a strikeout situation, but it's also a ground ball situation. I expect we'll see a lot of pitches down in the zone trying to prevent the hitter from getting the ball up in the air.
Long run for the center fielder, and the play is made, but this should be good enough for an RBI as the runner from third tags up. The run comes across to score, and they jump ahead 1-0. Next to stand in is Gabriel Arias. Bases empty and two gone following the sacrifice fly. On the ground to the right side. He'll get to this one deep in the hole. And the throw to first is in time, but the damage has been done as the side is retired. Bottom of the inning now, and now it'll be the catcher, Joseph Odom. Here's the 1-1 pitch. Count remains 2-2. Three and two.
When you're playing close games like this, base runners mean everything, so he can ill afford to start giving away free passes.
Fastball called, strike three, and there's the first out of the inning.
Batter, number seven, second baseman, Rudolph.
Might have jammed him a little there as this is softly hit and foul off to the left. Here now the 2-2. Line towards center field. But sadly for him, this will head straight to the center fielder as he puts it away without much trouble for the second out. Digging in will be Jordan Luplo. He grounded out last time up. And he comes back with a gorgeous slider there for strike two. Little chopper back to the mound. And that will conclude matters here in the seventh. Now to bat, Tyler Krieger. He's 0 for 2 thus far in this one. The 1-1. Skied in the air to straightaway left. Left fielder giving chase. Running hard. He's digging for second. And that one skips up over the wall for a ground rule double. To the plate now, Nolan Jones. Slider is in there, and now it's 1-2. And that's taken in straightaway right. Will he try from second? And he's safe. So a runner stands at third. One man is out. And the next to bat will be Josh Naylor.
The offensive approach here is simple. You know the pitcher's going for the K, so set your sights middle of the plate. And then don't worry about the infielders. They're so close, hard contact is a guarantee.
The count now at 2-2. This pitch is popped up. Walls takes charge, and he's got it. Two down. Now next up is Daniel Johnson, singled in his last at-bat. Looking to keep this a one-run game, the pitch. Back up the middle, and that is into center field as he comes through. It's a base hit, and now the runner from third scores to give them a very important insurance run.
Now that the center fielder, George Valera.
So now to the plate, George Valera. A swing and a miss as he chased with two strikes, and that will retire the side.
Yeah.
James Karinchak is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth.
Number 99. James.
Now to the plate here is Josh Lowe. He bounced out last time up. The 3-2 pitch. And he takes strike three called on the fastball. One gone. Digging in next, Jim Haley. No hits in three tries so far. He struck out once. The 1-1. One out, nobody on. And it's two balls and two strikes now.
Hey, you want someone sometimes to rattle the bat rack. But also, the guy on the mound's got to eat, too. They're executing their pitches out there. It's going to be tough to score some runs.
Another 2-2 offering.
Roll down. 3-2.
And it's another K. So back-to-back strikeout victims to start this relief outing.
Third baseman, number
and
three.
Now in the box, Grant Kay. He's been hit by a pitch and walked in the game thus far. And he can't catch the corner here, so he's behind 3-1.
A 3-1 count, tying run on deck. Good spot to be a hitter right now. You have to look for something middle in.
And he fouls this one off. Now the 3-2 pitch. Seventh pitch of the at-bat coming up. And he struck him out. So a fine inning here as he strikes out the side in order. Ryan Thompson enters from the pen to start the ninth inning as he'll try to keep the score right where it is heading to the bottom of the ninth. So striding in to start the ninth is Ernie Clement, trying to pad their lead here before the bottom of the inning.
That's a ball.
Ball three. You see a right-handed batter waiting next, but he could very well be pulled back as the situation dictates. And this pitch misses here. It's ball four, and they've got a leadoff base runner aboard to start the ninth.
Now batting, the catcher.
Now it'll be Ryan LaVarnway. Flew out last time up. Here comes the 1-2. Clement on at first, nobody out. Drilled to the right side. A dive, but he can't get it. It's through into the outfield. And that runner will hold up at second with two aboard now.
Now that second baseman, Aaron Bracho.
At the plate, Aaron Bracho. And look out as that one ran in and got her. Stepping in next, Gabriel Arias. He's got an opportunity to add to this lead, but the double play is in order. Needs a punch out here. Can he get it? Yes, he can. Strike three called, and that's a big out number one. Stepping up is Tyler Krieger, and he's got an opportunity to turn this narrow lead into a wide one if he can cash in here. Here's the 1-1. Changed things up on him, and he got him to swing through it. 1-2 now.
Boy, I love the way he's competing out there on the mound right now. He's got a chance to rack back-to-back K's with two runners in scoring position. He's not giving in at all.
Reined in. There's one on the first, but not in time as he beats it out. Ready now is Nolan Jones, and their runners at the corners now.
Nolan Jones.
Hit on the ground out to short. Fielded cleanly. And an underhanded throw is in time for out number three. Cam Hill takes the ball now in inning number nine, looking to close the door.
Number 27.
All set for the bottom of the ninth. And that'll bring up the outfielder, Nick Schnell. Well out in front of the breaking ball there for a strike.
He knows full well he's sitting on a hat trick right here. All he's trying to do is avoid the golden sombrero.
And, oh, he can't get out of the way of that one, so the leadoff man will be on to open the frame.
Now
next will be the designated hitter, Michael Brusso. It was a base hit last time up. And this is on the ground to short. Could be two. The second for one on to first, and that's the very last thing they needed at this point in the ball game, as there are quickly two away now. Now with the play, Taylor Walls, and he needs to make something happen. They're down to their final out here in the ninth. One strike from a shutout. Here it comes. And he gets strike three called to end it here. And with that, this one is over.
Hey, it sure feels good to shut somebody out. This was a 3-0 game that featured a lot of great pitching and timely hitting, which made the difference in this one.
And tonight's ends as a 3-0 shutout win. The Clippers jumped ahead in the seventh inning and never gave the lead back. Daniel Espino is credited with the win. So that'll just about do it. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. This has been a presentation of MLB The Show. For more, don't forget to check out theshow.com.
The final line score for our ball game: for the victorious Clippers, 3 runs, 6 hits, no errors. They left 9 runners on base. For the Bulls, 2 runs on only 2 hits, no errors. They left 8 men on base. Time of the ball game: 2 hours and 39 minutes. Thank you for joining us here this evening. We remind you to please drive home safely.